Hello everyone. In this session, let me introduce you to current chopping. Current chopping is a phenomenon that occurs in a circuit breaker when current interruption happens before the natural current zero occurs. Whenever we interrupt the current by the low resistance method, we wait for the natural current zero to occur and we extinguish the arc at natural current zero. But in case of using an air blast circuit breaker, the air blast circuit breaker is using the same extinguishing power irrespective of the magnitude of current, and there is a possibility to interrupt the current prematurely before the natural current zero occurs. So this is current chopping. And let me explain this considering an example. Consider a transformer which is taken away for maintenance. So when a transformer is removed for maintenance, the steps followed are the load is cut off. That is, the transformer is made to operate under no load condition. And when the transformer operates under no load condition, only the magnetizing current is drawn. This magnetizing current is a very low value of current when compared to the load current. And this low value of current is supposed to be interrupted by the circuit breaker. So in order to remove the transformer, we know we open the circuit breaker contacts and we remove it out of service. This scenario is explained by the following circuit representation. This is the transformer which is operating under no load condition, and this has to be removed by a circuit breaker. The inductance, the system inductance till the circuit breaker contact is L. C is the stray capacitance. And the generated voltage is represented as Vm sin omega t. Now, considering this system, let us trace the waveform and understand the phenomenon of current chopping. This represents the voltage Vm sin omega t. And for this voltage, there is a current in the power system network which lags behind the voltage by some angle because the power system network is inductive. The current is also assumed to be a pure sinusoidal waveform. According to the current chopping technique, we don't wait till the natural current zero occurs. Instead, we interrupt the current before the natural current zero occurs. So we interrupt the current at this point when we have a definite value for current. Current is abruptly now brought to zero. Immediately when the current is abruptly brought to zero, till I have a value of current I, there is some energy stored in the inductor, which is half L I square. This current is suddenly brought to zero, which means the energy stored in the inductor is now transferred to the capacitor, and the capacitor energy now becomes half CV square. Because of this, the capacitor voltage is set to increase. Cross multiplying and simplifying, we get the expression as V is equal to I root L by C. So this is an additional voltage that appears across the capacitor. Now, let us trace the waveform of the voltage across the circuit breaker contacts. The voltage across the circuit breaker contacts is almost equal to the voltage of the capacitor. So at the instant of fault we have, or at the instant of opening the circuit breaker, we have an arc, and the arc voltage is in phase with the fault current, because the arc voltage and current are in phase because the arc is resistive. So this is the pattern of arc voltage. But now the current value is abruptly brought to zero, and because the current is abruptly brought to zero, voltage is increased across the capacitor. Voltage is increased across the capacitor, and it increases to some value, and this value is sufficient enough to restrike the arc again across the circuit breaker contact. So when the arc is restriked, so it decreases, and then we have conduction because of the air blast. The current is interrupted again. So because of this interruption, again the voltage builds up, and then arc is again struck again, continues, again interrupted because of the circuit breaker action. So there are multiple restrikes before the arc completely gets extinguished. So at this natural current zero, when the arc is completely interrupted, the voltage tends to take the pattern of the system voltage, that is the voltage across the capacitor is going to be the voltage, the supply voltage, but that doesn't happen smoothly. Instead, we have some transient because of the inductance and capacitance, and then we have the recovery voltage appearing across the circuit breaker contacts. And these transients could be reduced by use of resistance switching method, which we have already learned. So resistance switching method is one where when the circuit breaker contacts are open, a braking resistance along with an auxiliary switch is connected across the circuit breaker contact, and by carefully choosing a value of resistor, these oscillations could be suppressed. So these oscillations could be suppressed, and this is current chopping. Now let us discuss current chopping by use of a problem. Consider a transformer operating at 220 kV, taking a magnetizing current of 10 ampere. Calculate the voltage across the breaker contacts if the current is chopped at 5 ampere and if the current is chopped at 2.5 ampere. Given L is equal to 100 Henry and C is equal to 0.004 microfarad. And we know after simplification, V is equal to I into root of L by C. Substitute the value of I as 5 ampere in first case, and the voltage is calculated to be 790 kV when current 5 ampere is interrupted, or when we have 5 ampere, when we abruptly bring it to zero, 790 kilovolt is the voltage that is appearing across the breaker contact. So this voltage is sufficiently large enough to break down the medium between the contacts, and that causes a restrike. If a current of 2.5 ampere is interrupted, the voltage is 395 kV, a little lesser voltage, right? It could be seen that when lower values of current are interrupted, The voltage that appears across the circuit breaker contacts is low, and this explains the current chopping phenomenon and the consequence of current chopping phenomenon. Thank you.